So the championship series is underway. Both series are two games in. Let's talk about this. Let's start with this ALCS between the Rangers and Astros, which the Rangers played really well in these first two games. They're obviously up 2-0 in this series. And honestly, I did think Houston was going to win one of their home games. I think they're going to win both, but I mean, they got absolutely destroyed. So not the way I thought this series was going to go, in my opinion. So first game, Houston obviously comes out pretty flat. They don't score. So really solid job from the Rangers pitching staff. Jordan Montgomery had a really good game that day. I mean, he's been really solid. I mean, this guy's getting a bag in the postseason because he's a free agent. So excited to see what his thing's going to look like in the offseason. But hey, I mean, this team is phenomenal this year. And then, you know, the first game, I mean, they just played well. I mean, they obviously get two runs off Verlander eventually. Takes them a little bit to get kind of used to everything. You know, these teams haven't played in, well, I think 4 days each. So a couple days off, kind of low scoring first game. And then we head into game two, 5-4 Texas wins. I mean, they put up four in the first inning. That was insane. You know, you get Corey Seager on, you get Semien on in the first two pitches of the game. Semien, you know, obviously he's been struggling this postseason, so it's nice to see him getting some hits. We like to see that for Marcus Semien, you know, because his team's been kind of carrying him low-key. And they just played well. I mean, you put up four in that first thing. Helm gets the home run later in the game. I mean, you know, you kind of struggle. You know, I think Yordan's been a really good key for this Astros squad. He's literally been one of the reasons they've been in these games at all. And I think he's got the most postseason home runs for a Cuban player, which is a pretty exciting stat. I think he's tied at 12 right now, so I think he needs one more or something like that. He played out of his mind in that game, too. He's been really solid for the Astros. I mean, he's just that guy in the postseason. I don't know what to say on him. Yeah, heading into this game, 3, 4, and 5 in Arlington, going to be very interesting to see how these go. I mean, Texas, once again, has not lost a game. So they're 7-0 in the postseason. We'll see if they're going to sweep this series. I mean, it's looking like this, you know, with the game 3 and 4 matchups that we have right now. But man, it'd be really interesting if they sweeped, because, I mean, it's kind of crazy to think about. I did not think this series would go this way. But hey, I mean, they're both on top, really dominant performances from the Rangers pitching staff. Going into the Rangers home series, I think the Astros are going to win one game. I think they win one game here. I don't know if they really have a shot to win the series at this point. I mean, this team just looks so destroyed now. But if they can kind of catch some momentum here and get something going, I mean, you never know. So I do think Texas wins the series in Arlington. So I don't really think we're going back to Houston, to be honest. So we'll be interested to see what happens. But man, it's so hard for me to predict the Astros right now. And going over to the NLCS, once again, this has been a really interesting series. I mean, Philly comes out strong again at game one. They win 5-3. Arizona kind of had a fight back, but not really. I mean, they did put up 3 runs. I mean, Perdomo's been playing pretty well for them in this series. So it's kind of the only positive right there. But yeah, the pitching has not been it. I mean, Philly's been hitting so many home runs, it seems like, this whole postseason, and definitely in these two games, at least. In my opinion, I think they had 3 or 4 home runs in the first game and even more in the second game, so pretty crazy overall. So yeah, the first game they won 5-3. The second game was 10-0. They were able to win that one. So insane across the board. I mean, I saw the whole Merrill Kelly thoughts. I kind of agree with him, to be honest. I don't really think he was trying to insult anyone. I think he was just wondering if it was going to be louder, you know, the World Baseball Classic games in Miami, because they were loud. If you guys watch those series, they were really loud. I don't know if Philly's matching up to that potential, but it does seem like it. Yeah, so everyone kind of got on him about that, and you know how those fans are over there, so they're definitely going to get on about that. But now we're going back to Arizona for the next 3 games in this series, and Philly's up 2-0, so I don't think they sweep, though. I really don't think they sweep. I think Arizona's going to put up a good fight in these next 3 games. I think they're definitely going to win 2 out of 3 and go back to Philly for that game 6, in my opinion. So I'm feeling really confident in this Arizona squad still. You know, they obviously played really good at home in that one game that they had. So I'm looking for Arizona to win a couple games here, and I think it's going to happen. We know Chase Field is pretty hard to hit home runs in, especially in that center field area. So this field might actually help them with the home field advantage, because Arizona, I mean, they do hit home runs, but they don't really rely on it. I feel like the Phillies are kind of in this series. So I think Arizona definitely has a huge advantage going home, especially with their fans, right, and their stadium, and they know how it's going to play. So I definitely think this is a good advantage for, you know, the Diamondbacks. And I definitely think if they can stop this home run ball, they have a really good shot to win this series, because they do kind of rely on it, the Phillies, at least in my opinion. I think it's their kind of, they live and die by it. Because you look at sometimes when they don't hit home runs, it's been pretty low scoring games. So you kind of got to think about it like that. Overall, though, I think these next 3 home games, I feel like Arizona's winning 2 out of 3. You know, I think they're going to go up. I think Philly's going to go up 3-2. And then they're going to go back to Philadelphia for that game 6, and if there's a 7th game. So that's kind of how I'm seeing this. I think there's a fight back from the Diamondbacks. I'm not sure about the Astros, though. And I think I did say in my predictions videos, I think I said Rangers and the Diamondbacks. So we'll see if this is still right. We're more right on the AL than the NL, it looks like. Let me know you guys' thoughts are on both of these series. It's been very fun to watch baseball. I've been really enjoying the championship series. And I think I like it even better that there's no really big name teams anymore. I mean, we kind of got rid of all those teams. We got the Rangers in here, which have, I mean, technically a big name team, but not compared to like the Yankees or any of those squads, right? And same thing with the Diamondbacks. I think, you know, the Diamondbacks are not the most known team. They've only been in the league for a little bit. So it's very nice to see them here as well. But if you guys do enjoy this video, I'm very excited for game 3, 4, and 5 of the championship series coming up. Should be exciting. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below about both of these series. And with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out, everyone.